All right, so I texted Joe this morning to ask him if he had time to do this, and he said he was busy, and then like 2 hours later, the Bills traded Stephon Diggs, and now we're both here at the stadium, so I kind of am forcing him into doing this. What happened? How did we get to this point?
Well, I think that's kind of a convoluted answer, but...
If there's anybody who can give me.
Yes, well, I think for one, you look at just the logic behind it. When they have... You know, this entire offseason based around kind of clearing cap space in 2025. I think that's been kind of the thing I've been noticing about their moves more than anything. And that's what this kind of screams out, outside of all of the other factors that I think are pretty well known. You know, the drama that has kind of followed around with Stephon Diggs in the past couple of seasons. But I think... clearing the amount of cap space they did in 2025 and maximizing the value for a now 30-year-old receiver, I think just from a roster building standpoint, that's what kind of makes the most sense. So getting a future second, which might possibly be an early second round pick, because Minnesota has taken perhaps one of the biggest step backs of anyone in the league this year. Their quarterback's gone. They have Sam Darnold and who the heck knows, insert rookie quarterback here. From that, and then clearing the $27 million on the cap next year and having the cap space to eat all the dead cap this year, I think that's what made the most sense to them.
The natural question now that everybody has is, what do they do at wide receiver? I don't think it's going to be like, okay, wide receiver one leaves and they just find another one who can immediately step into that role. But what do you think is the most realistic outlook? Is it, okay, draft somebody at 28? Is it take a bunch of picks and put them together and move up? Is it sign somebody and draft? Like, what do they need to do to make their wide receiver room not so scarce? Because it is pretty scarce right now.
I think anything is on the table, but my money would be on the draft. In some capacity, whether it be trading up or standing pat and taking one. You know, they could conceivably do exactly what they did with Stephon Diggs and, you know, trade a higher pick for a guy who's in his prime, pay him, and then go from there. That kind of puts you in the same spot.
Yeah.
One thing that they haven't done is they haven't gone young and cheap at the receiver position, when so many of these young receivers that we've seen come in the league just absolutely rock out, for lack of a better term, and be on a cost-effective rookie deal for 4 seasons, and then you have the fifth-year option on them. So I think that could be the most, I guess, attractive route for this year, especially since they have basically cleared up all the cap space they've needed to for 2025 to where they can be players in the free agent market next year. I mean, the Diggs trade and cutting Von Miller alone will clear up $36 million next year. So that is a big consideration. And when you pair that with potentially a number one receiver for the future, I think that is a situation that that Bean is eager to kind of get toward, because they haven't had that just yet.
From a strictly football standpoint, how much does this hurt the Bills in their outlook in the short term, this upcoming season?
Well, they took away their best offensive weapon outside of Josh Allen. I mean, it's pretty simple that they will take a hit because of it. But they're now hoping, now that Josh Allen has gotten to the point, because Stephon Diggs helped him get to this point, right? Like, he was not the franchise quarterback guy when Stephon Diggs came to town. Now he is. Now they are looking at Josh Allen to take that next step in his career, where he is amplifying everyone around him, as opposed to needing to rely on a locked-in, number one, no-doubt-about-it receiver like he had with Stephon Diggs. Not saying that he can't do it, not saying he can do it, but it's something that they are hoping for moving forward, that he can raise the level of the talent around him.
I feel like in 2019, Josh Allen needed Stephon Diggs. Now the Bills need Josh Allen to play like a franchise quarterback, even without Stephon Diggs. That's Joe Buscaglia. I'm Matt Bove. We're going to talk about this for, I don't know, the next 5 months or something, but that's what we got right now.